Why it will never work with a narcissist. If you're stuck in a relationship with an abusive person, whoever they are in your life, and they keep promising to change, and as most people do, we cling on to the hope that they will change. Because of those intermittent reinforcements of their idolization stage when they play nice, or even when we've got out and people can still be trauma bonded and want them back, and you can become trauma bonded to an ex-partner, friends, parents, any narcissistic person in your life. Then they come back with all the false promises of change, and you might think they're not that bad. Here are a few reasons to remind you why you'll never be genuinely able to make it work with a narcissist. I'm Elizabeth Shaw. Welcome to the channel, which is all about the narcissistic personality disorder, to give you more understanding of what you've been through, how to handle them if you cannot go no contact, and most importantly, how to recover from narcissistic abuse and live your best life for you. If you are new to the channel, please do subscribe. Can't speak this morning. Videos are released weekly, so check in if you're in that place, in that state of mind where you want to listen. If you want notifications, hit the bell. Thank you very much to all the returning subscribers. Your support really helps getting awareness out there, and I hope you're all doing much better than when you first subscribed. Narcissist, trying to make it work with one, it just doesn't work. Nothing about their idolization stage is real. It's all to hook you in and keep you trapped. They treat you better than anyone ever has treated you. Everything is perfect, and you believe you've met the one, your one true love, your soulmate, whatever you believe in, and you're living the fairy tale dream. Unfortunately, none of that is real. Though you live it, so it is reality, but they've mirrored everything about you. All your loves, all your hates, or you fell in love with yourself in reality. And you can leave that narcissist be, rebuild your life and fall in love with you all over again. Or if you had a narcissistic parent, you can learn how to fall in love with yourself. The best relationship you can have is the one with yourself. And then you give the best of yourself to others and you walk away from those negative, toxic people so much easier. If it was your parents, you believe your parent has learned their behaviour has hurt you, and they shall be kinder towards you. Your children can have a grandparent. Unfortunately, whenever they come play nice, it's only because they want something from you. With parents, neighbours, friends, people in your workplace, or your child's narcissistic parent, depending on how toxic they are, how well you know yourself, you can try using Level Up, which is limited contact. When they act nice, give them attention, not too much. And when they work spitefully towards you, give them nothing other than grey rock. A narcissist learns everything they can about you and feeds you a false reality, letting you see and believe everything you want to see and believe. They'll use all your strengths, all your insecurities, all your weaknesses, all your vulnerabilities against you. You have to know yourself so well that they can no longer use you against you to be able to do Level Up with them. Narcissistic people have two faces. The admiration face, when they treat you so well to gain positive attention from you, and you live that reality when they treat you well. Yet they have the envious face when they are jealous of you or something that you might achieve, and they treat you so wrong to pull you down, to hurt you, to stop you achieving, stop you living your life for you. This is who they are. They have a disorder and it's who they are. Just because someone can treat you right one minute doesn't entitle them to treat you wrong the next. And as hard as it is to start, you don't have to put up with their hurtful, toxic behaviours towards you. As soon as they believe they've got you hooked enough, you'll do anything to keep them happy. they'll change that, they'll flick that switch on you from black to white. Like, nothing you do will ever be good enough. You might get something right for a day, a week, a month, or even a year with some. Then they'll change the rules of the game on you and you'll get it oh so wrong again. You cannot keep a narcissist happy because they cannot keep themselves happy. When you try time and time again to get it right, to keep them happy, your mental and physical health deteriorates and you get sick and tired. And often we don't walk away until we are so sick and tired of being sick and tired. While trying to please them with all the manipulation and gaslighting they use, you slowly lose who you are, your boundaries, your self-worth, your dignity, your respect, and you start walking on eggshells, blaming yourself through the words that the narcissist has drip-fed your mind. Yet, because you think it's your fault and you want the person you met back, you wish your parents would be proud of you, you want an easy life at work, you feel you cannot walk away from that childhood friend, you try to please them time and time again. They'll bring that idolization stage back in for a while to keep you further confused while they slowly devalue you behind your back and to your face, in covert ways and overt ways. Every time you think you've worked it out, they change the game on you. Yet often we still don't give up. We still try and try, as through all the manipulation and gaslighting, we believe within ourselves that we were the ones at fault, even though our instincts can be screaming at us as we don't know what they are saying, our minds override them. But your mind is talking to you how the narcissist has programmed you to talk to yourself. You may live in fear of them or believe you're worthless and you don't deserve any better. You may think that no one will love you, fear of being alone, fear of judgment from others, and that you need to try harder. And it's that fear that they place into you of those things that keeps you trapped and locked within that relationship. Whatever you do, nothing is good enough for them. You feel like you're getting depressed and going crazy around them. You may feel like you don't deserve them and that no one else will ever care about you or love you as they do or they did. That it's all your fault. They're not giving you any attention. And even when you sat there in tears of pain, heartbreak, and desperation, they seem to just stand there almost smirking at you. Not that you always notice that smirk at the time. And they'll be gaslighting you and telling you things like, it's your fault and you need to sort yourself out. They may even get you to the doctors for antidepressants and into counselling for you, and this is only so they can sink you further into depths of despair and help in their smear campaign against you. Your parents are never truly happy for you, always chipping away at something you have or haven't done. You're not as successful as they want you to be, for example. You've not got the job they wanted you to have. You didn't help them enough. And no matter what you do, you feel like you failed them, making you feel a failure within yourself, when what you need to do is what makes you happy, the career you want for you, regardless of what they think or say about you. You are here to be yourself and enjoy life for who you are and who you want to be, not to please your parents. And if you prove them wrong and you are successful in something they didn't want you to be in, they'll either try to take credit for you for what you've achieved, or they will further put you down over it in some, either the over way, the obvious way, where they'll just be telling you you're not good enough, or in the covert way when they'll be telling you they think you'd be better doing something else, or because they're afraid of your success, of you being happy and living your life. One minute A narcissist will treat you better than anyone ever has, and the next worse than anyone ever has, leaving you unsure as to where you stand with your parents or your friends, leaving you wanting those good times, feeling so alone at times while in a relationship, a personal relationship with one, leaving you hurt and confused. Then they will bring you back up to send you crashing back down, which is releasing so many natural hormone chemicals into your body. You do become addicted to their abusive behavior. And when you do break free, you are then faced with weaning yourself off those chemicals. You are weaning yourself off a drug. All those silent treatments, disappearing acts, hurtful actions towards you that they most likely gaslighted you and told you you made them do it. And it leaves you with that self-doubt. Those were never your fault. Slowly but surely, they pick you apart piece by piece. You're lost in a maze as they've most likely isolated you from other friends and family members. The only person you have to turn to is them. And as they drip feed you more false reality of that didn't happen and if only you'd do this, you get further and further lost. They change the games on you. They up their manipulative games on you time and time again. Yet there is no rules to these games. There's only one winner in a narcissistic relationship, and that is the narcissist. They promise to do something and then don't deliver, gaslighting you again with phrases like, "I never said that." They'll make plans with you and then not say anything to you and just change the plans at the last minute, or they'll make plans without you and then they'll be saying to you, "I told you last week." And even though you know they didn't, if you question them, it'll be more gaslighting of you're losing your memory, you're losing your mind, you're going crazy. They'll ruin holidays, birthdays, Christmases and special occasions or any event where they are not the centre of attention. They place you into a unsettled state of mind. Then they'll go all happy and full of life to the event, making you look grumpy and crazy to help with their smear campaign against you. When they are getting ready to discard you for someone new, and a narcissist can do this with new partners, a new friend, or idolization of old partners, old friends. They can do it in a workplace, parents playing siblings or family members off against each other. When that someone new to the narcissist isn't working how they wanted, they'll swoop back in with the Hoover and the false promises. And as you've not If you've not released all that trauma bond, you'll be grateful that they've come back to make amends, and the cycle just begins again. The only way to break it is to get out and stay out. No contact or grey rock. Nothing will ever change. They are not accountable and do not see themselves as the problem. They are stuck with who they are. They either don't know what they are and see no reason to change, or they know and still don't believe they have to change. They still go around blaming all others. If they know what they are or not is irrelevant. Change for them is just not an option, as they always think they are right. They do not have that cognitive reflection to look back and see what part they played in anything. Once they've made their minds up, once they've made their truths up, that is it to them, which is why they can lie so convincingly. They believe it works for them, as they have to keep power and control over all others. If they cannot do it directly, they'll try and do it indirectly, using the smear campaign. Positive or negative attention, they don't really mind. Attention is attention to them. A relationship with a narcissist will only ever sink you. With some, you need to get out and stay out safely. Some are physically violent. Some are dangerous. Others are mentally violent, and mental abuse is devastating and has devastating effects on people. And once you know who they are and no longer take part in their wicked games that you didn't even know you were in to begin with until years down the line. You can then go for limited contact, whatever that limited contact is for you. Only you know how dangerous that narcissist is, what you've truly been through, and whether it needs to be no contact or whether you can manage limited contact. I always recommend no contact with these people. Realistically, though, if they were a partner and you had no children, it's easier to do. Yet a friend that you might bump into when you see other good friends, a parent or a sibling that you might see at a family event, or those work colleagues that just seem to have it in for you, or if you have children with them, no contact isn't always entirely realistic. When no contact isn't always going to work for you, learn no and stick to your boundaries. No means no. Learning about them so you know the games they're playing and you can counteract those games. As well as learning what you're dealing with, learning about you and what you want from life also helps you navigate your way through life and yourself around toxic people. Learning to focus your mind onto what it is you want to do from or with your life now. As much as you try to move away from pain, your mind may still be focused on it, meaning your emotions will still be focused on it. I'll add a video into the description about how to handle your emotions. Humans are designed to survive at all costs. Therefore, you will focus on the pain to find subconscious coping methods for your fight for survival. Human minds are more interested in survival than they are in your happiness. So your mind is always on the lookout for that danger. The narcissist will have caused you lots of pain through manipulation, words, and possible physical violence. And now your brain is focused on them, which confuses your mindset even more. If your subconscious is filling your mind with negativity, it will take you there. So now you need to take control of your mind consciously. Think positive thoughts, visualize them in your mind, or if you look at old photos, you'll notice you can subconsciously take yourself there to those feelings, to what was happening. Looking at new things you want from your life and consciously take yourself there. Imagine what it would be like to have the things that you want from your life now. Feel the emotions like you've already achieved these new dreams until you train your subconscious to focus on the new direction you want to take your life now. And you will find a way to get there. Undoing your subconscious programming takes work, yet that work is worth it. Losing your limiting beliefs that are stuck in your subconscious takes practice. To pull these all up and out and changing the way you talk to yourself from I cannot to I can. Transforming I'm not good enough to I am good enough. You'll have to consciously pick yourself up on the negative self-talk and reprogram what's been programmed into you over a long period of time. And it's going to feel uncomfortable, just like learning anything new. Mistakes will be made. Do not beat yourself up over them. Instead, recognize, learn, and grow from these mistakes. Turn your thinking from I have a problem to I have a challenge, and then find a solution to that challenge. Write down your goals and start taking action in achieving them. Focus your time and energy into putting positive affirmations into your mind, consciously removing any negative ones. It's time to reprogram your mindset into a positive, happy person to where you want to be. We're allowed days off. Just deal with them and move past them. Start working on your mindset and your future today. Repeatedly telling yourself what it is you want and then going out there and working on it and getting it from you, for you, until you've reprogrammed your subconscious to how you want it to work for you. What you resist persists. What you focus on grows stronger. So keep those positive thoughts. Great things can happen for you. You have the power and the strength within you to take action to achieve them. So start thinking about what you do want from your life and then go to work on achieving it. Anything is possible. If you can see someone else doing something You can do that too if you want to do it. I know it's difficult to start. I've lived it myself. I'm a few years down the line, but once you start working on your life, where you want to be, it does get a lot easier. So many people have survived this and lived a much happier life from it. And it doesn't matter how old you are, you still have time to change how you want the direction of your life to go. I shall add the video in the description about overcoming your emotions. Signs of a narcissist, in case you're still unsure, but whether they are a narcissist or not, if someone is abusive towards you, if someone puts you down, they are not for you. I shall also add in the description the links to the online courses. The Break Free from Narcissistic Abuse does give a step-to-step guide from No Contact, Grey Rock, All About the Narcissist. There's lots of information in there. I am currently working through it and adding some new things into that. Thank you very much for listening. And today, write down three things that you would like to have achieved by next year at this time and see what steps you can take to start getting yourself in that direction to achieve them. And think about actually being there next year at this time. Think about actually having those goals and those dreams that you want. Thank you very much for listening. Anyone has any advice, please add it into the comments, because we do all have different perceptions. So what helps one person doesn't always help another. That comment might just help one person. Thank you very much for listening. Bye.